Welcome to Lisa's Pine Notes. My name is Lisa, and today we are going to do a very quick how-to on the dragonfly shape, and I wish to thank each and every one of you out there who sent me well wishes while I got over the bad cold in March and completely lost my voice. As you can tell, I'm still a little scratchy, but we're going to do this real quick. And do remember, if this is your first time here, I am a beginner crocheter with 2 years under my belt, and this is the first time I really ventured out to create a shape because I wasn't happy with what I found out there. And yes, we're talking about a dragonfly shape. When Mandala yarn by Lion Brand came to be for sale, I immediately saw this very colorway and thought, oh, I've got to do a dragonfly in this. And I was very unhappy with all the patterns I was finding out there. So today, although I'm a beginner crocheter, if you're a beginner, you should know how to double crochet, chain, and do a magic circle, or at least know how to start a double crochet shawl making a chain four. So we'll go over that real quick. I'm not going to teach basic stitches in this, only how to do the beautiful dragonfly shape. And if you follow me on Instagram, where I'm active daily, it is Lisa Pine Notes, and I went through an evolution of changing the shapes. Right here in front of you is a basic double crochet scarf. You can add a dragonfly to that. A basic double crochet shawl. You can add a dragonfly to that. I wasn't happy with the shape until I came upon my final version here, and all that changed is the top wingspan is longer than my previous version underneath it and the previous version in the scarf. So if you can do a double crochet, you can do a dragonfly shape. So I'm going to clear the table. What you're going to need is a size J hook, or a 6mm, which is my preferred hook for the Mandala yarn. Note that you can also do this in, yes, my holy grail yarn, Red Heart Super Saver, Unforgettable Boutique. This color happens to be stained glass, and yes, I would still use a size J hook in that. And I did a little quick sample for us out of the TealBerry, and yes, it works up just fine. And I'll insert better pictures for you to see. But here's our three-tail dragonfly shape with the longer wingspan here. And I prefer, honestly, something that changes color a little slower, like Mandala. However, do know, if you've got Red Heart in your stock and you want to try this, go for it. Absolutely made a beautiful shawl there. And I'm going to clear the table and come right back. Let's gather our supplies. And we are back with our supplies. Today I am using the Mandala yarn in the color Spirit. And if this looks familiar, that's because this is my not-so-blue Blue Jay Poncho color. I had an extra one left, so I'm going to be using that today. And do remember, this is a simple double crochet pattern that you can add to anything you have, like a scarf, that is in double crochet. I happen to be making a shawl today, and we'll show you how real quick. Now, I like to start my shawls with a magic circle. You can certainly chain four and slip stitch together if you are more comfortable with that. Now, as any double crochet shawl or scarf starts, you're going to chain three up and then start doing double crochets. So we're going to put two into this magic circle to get started here for a total of three, because your chain counts as one. You will be doing a chain three and two double crochets for each start from here on out. You're going to chain two. This will make the nice spine in your shawl here. And you're going to place three double crochet right here in the magic circle. As soon as you get past this fussy part, it will go so much smoother and quicker, especially if you're a new crocheter. And again, I invite you to add this three-tail dragonfly shape, which is what I'm calling it, three-tail dragonfly shape, to any of your favorite crochet patterns out there. And basically, that is what it's going to look like. And what this is this tiny piece right here. If I flip it over, it's that tiny piece right there. And we're going to chain three up. One, two, and three. We're going to turn our work and pull on our tail here. There you go. And I'm going to place two double crochet in this very end spot. This is very important because this is how you're going to start and finish every edge of your piece for this particular shawl, which is similar. I keep saying that it's any pattern you find for a double crochet shawl out there. And after you make that, we're simply going to make double crochets in those spaces. This is where we start to grow. Right on top. And then right in that chain two space, we're going to continue on with our spine work for our shawl, which is right here. This is our spine work, if you want to look at it that way. Somehow I flipped my yarn around the camera. Only I could do that. My mom calls me Spider for a reason. Here we go. Chain two, just like you did in the previous row. And right in that same space, you're going to make two more double crochet. And double crochet on the top of each of those stitches till you get to the very end here. And if you're not a beginner and know how to start your own double crochet shawls or scarves, go ahead and I'll put in the minutes where the actual magic starts, where we start doing the dragonfly itself. All right, here we go. We're on our very end piece. Now, if you can't get... Yes, Lisa, stop doing your chain so tight. If you can't get into that last chain, go ahead and double crochet around it. I told you that in the virus shawl tutorial too. Keep the chains nice and loose on the ends. There's two double crochet in that last piece, and my last double crochet managed to fit there. Now we're going to chain three up, keeping that stitch nice and loose. One, two, and three, and turn, diving right back in and doing two double crochet. Working each into the top of each double crochet, till you get to your chain 2 space. And if you're a beginner, feel free to put a safety pin or a stitch marker there to help you out. So you know how to do this basic part. We have this right here, so we're going to do this 1, 2, 3, 4 more times. So go ahead and repeat what I just showed you 4 more times, and then join me for the 5th row, which would be the start of the wing. And welcome back. You should have your simple double crochet starter piece right like so. And if you are doing a scarf, you should have done all your crochet up until your starting point. And I'll explain this first and then we'll get back to this. You're going to count your stitches in any project you're doing for the wingspan that I'm about to show you. In this case, I did 2 front post double crochet and a set of crochet to fit the entire wingspan of my pattern. Any double crochet project can use this 3-tail dragonfly shape. And here is the pattern that I was mentioning. Don't mind my scribble here. And believe me, I rewrote this from the original. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to make 2 more double crochet. And again, we'll do this together. And then start to chain our first arch of the beautiful dragonfly shape. We're going to loosely, not pull down tightly, single crochet in the middle on the 9th. We're going to chain 8 more and make our double crochets for the other side. So basically, what you need is 17 spaces. So you should have at least 17 spaces here. And I can tell you, I stopped at 22. So we'll be fine. And let's remember, what did we learn when we did our virus shawl? Fold your piece to make sure it matches on both sides from the spine. So count. But if you want a quick check, especially when you start getting your shapes down, fold the piece to make sure you've got a matching set there. And of course, I'm a little ahead of the game here. So let's continue on with the shape. Now, this will never change, as I mentioned before. In any double crochet, you're going to have a starter piece to grow your shawl. And that is a chain 3, 2 double crochet. That's your starter piece. It's not going to change here. I'm going to add now what I call bumper pieces. And for a beginner crocheter, that means if I'm one off, these are my safety net from my shape. And yes, it does happen. And no, you know, you don't want a frog sometimes. I'm learning. So, bumper pieces in place here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we're going to chain 8. Please make your chains beautiful, because this is your wing that's going to show. We don't want them twisted. And let's count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if we chain 8 up here, that means we're skipping 8 spaces down here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on the 9th, just like in golf, on the 9th, we're going to single crochet nice and loose in there, because we're going to be using that stitch again. Don't tug down too hard. And we're going to do 8 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What are we going to do again? Count our spaces again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On the 9th, Double crochet. We're starting our double crochets again on the 9th, just like in golf. So if that helps you remember it. And what's this? Yes, our bumper 2 double crochets at the end. There you go. So you did your starter piece, which was your chain 3 and 2 double crochet in the same stitch. You did your bumper of 2 double crochet. You chained 8 and skipped 8. And in the 9th, you made a single crochet. You chained 8 more, skipped 8 more, and in the 9th, double crochet to grow that wing back. Because this is his little body. This single crochet is his little body. And this is never going to change either. Your spine will not change. You're going to place 2 double crochet in there. You're going to chain 2. And you're going to repeat what you just did. So, what does that mean? That means that we're going to make 2 bumpers, double crochet. We're going to chain 8. Make your chains nice. Do remember, I'm working around a camera, so I can't exactly see my stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and here we are, skipping 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, in the 9th, single crochet. This is our dragonfly body right here. Please do it loosely, don't tug down. We're going to need that shape. All right, here we go, 8 more. Six, seven, eight. Let's check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, double crochet. We need our bumper, so I'm going to pre-wrap. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and yes, in the 9th. Just like in golf, in the 9th. Oh, that sounded more like a horse race. Sorry. There we go. And yes, keep your chains on the end a little bit looser than I do. You think I'd learn by now. Wrap it around if you can. In your chain, wrap it around. That's just fine. 1, 2, and 3. There you go. You should have identical matching sides. I'm going to chain 3 up and then put it down real quick. And turn. Here we go. Now that you have the basic main wing, it's going to get a whole lot easier after this because you've got the pattern down. You've got chain 3. 2 double crochet in the first space. You have your bumper 2 double crochet. You have your chain 8, a single crochet in the 9th for the first body part. Chain 8 again, a double crochet up here by the spine to grow that wing back out from the body. Your bumpers, 2 double crochet. Your normal spine, which is 2 double crochet. 2 chain, 2 double crochet, bumpers again, 2 double crochet, your chain 8, and in the 9th, a single crochet for his body, chain 8 again, and remember, you're growing the body back out, so your 2 bumper double crochets, and your lovely starting and ending piece, which is the chain, I'm sorry, it is the 3 double crochets in that chain. Remember, chain loosely. All right, let's get to part 2. Part 2, a little bit different. What we're going to do is our bumper pieces, but in that last stitch where we started, we're going to do two together double crochets. That's going to give us a slightly angled edge here. See right there and right there. That's going to give us the slightly angled edge because dragonfly wings aren't the same shape top and bottom. And we're going to do that. So if we're double crocheting two together, that means we only need to chain seven. We're going to single crochet into that previous single crochet. We're going to chain seven again and then double crochet two together to start making our second wing. So let's do that. As you guys know, I've already chained three, and in front of you I chain loosely. By myself I do not. Alright. Starter piece, which is your turning chain and two double crochet. Bumper pieces, we're going to double crochet, keep going to that last one, double crochet, two of them in the same space, chain seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is why it was important to keep your single crochet a little bit loose, because we're going to single crochet to make his body. Here we go. So right in the middle of that single crochet, I'm making his body. And we're going to come back with another chain seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have to pull some more yarn. Double crochet. So you almost don't have to count after you lay out your base for the first wing of the dragonfly, because it intuitively tells you what to do. You just gotta remember to put two double crochets in that last space. And look at, see how it's a tiny bit littler? And that's what we want. Continue on. Here's your bumpers. Two double crochet. And another one. This is how your pattern grows right here. And into that chain two space, the spine stays the same. Two double crochet, chain two. Yeah, I don't know if you guys can hear my blue jay complaining out there. It's good to be back. Good to be a normal recording day with blue jays singing. It is a rainy day in Ohio though today, and cold, 37 last night. Happy April 1st. Let's see, here we go. Double crocheting right on top till we reach the last one. Two double crochet in that spot. 1, 2, chain seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, single crochet right in that middle. Move those stitches out of your way if you need to. Right in the middle. Be careful not to split your yarn. Single crochet, and there's his body. Chain seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Two double crochet. Let's close this wing up. One, two. two right in the same space. Finishing off your two bumpers. One and two. And yes, let's see if she did. Now, if you want to know, sometimes this confused me when I was doing this. So I just go back here and look. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So count over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. And let's see if I left that chain loose enough. No, I didn't, so I'm going around. Boy, I was with you guys, too. All right. 1, 2, and 3. Chain 3 up. 1, 2, 3. Turn 2 double crochet. Now this gets easy. Really, really easy. Alright, let's put it down and look at it. There's your wing. The hardest part is done, guys. We're just going to double crochet now. Taking my yarn over. Here we go. We are doing single crochet, chain one space, three times. The rest is all your double crochets. So, here we go. Double crocheting till we get to this wing. Double crocheting. I know it's going to be weird double crocheting in that wing space, but that's what we're doing right here. Oh, I'm glad it's even a different color. You can see that real good. The rest is just double crochet, except for the tail. Nothing special on that last one, just double crochet. All right, now, you remember you had a chain 7 here. That means you're going to do 7 double crochet, and I'm going to see how this goes wrapped around the camera and holding the space. I've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 7. Now I'm going to put this down just so we can move them. The way I'm holding it, it's not as spread out as it should be. But here, just move them nicely along that chain. And right now, you are on top of his body right here. And what you're going to do to make that space to make his tail, this is part one of the three-part tail, chain one. And 7 more double crochet in that chain 7 space. I told you guys this was so easy. I love dragonflies. It may be because I grew up by a lake. There's a lot of marshes around here. Do you know dragonflies don't bite? If you catch one, they're just using their very strong jaws to get you to let them go. They don't have a stinger. And why I mention that is because I'm going to say stinger here pretty soon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Very good. Double crochet on the top of that chain. Told you it was all going to be double crochet here on out. Coming up to our spine piece. Nothing has changed there either. Right in the middle Let's put our two double crochet for the spine. Again, use a stitch marker or a safety pin if you need to know where your spine is. Or you're working with thinner yarn and can't see it as well. That's fine too. They call this a size 3, and this is a Mandala by Lion Brand again. And do remember, I am not affiliated with any companies. Lion Brand just happens to make fantastic products, and you guys all know my Red Heart Super Saver too. But they are calling this a size 3 weight. It's a tiny bit bigger, I think. Coming up, I told you, lots of double crocheting here. So I'm going down almost to the last one. I remember that was our double crochet from the previous row. Right on top, double crochet, and into that chain 7 space. I'm going to pull some more yarn, and we're going to make 7 double crochets here. Alright, you guys already saw me do that on the other side. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we'll lay that down one more time. I'm going to move my spaces over and make sure I have 7 right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, we're to his body again. Look at that. It's like he's got a little head and 2 eyes there. And we're just going to chain 1 and skip on over to the other wing. 7 double crochet. Seven, I'm going to count real quick. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep. Keep double crocheting to the end. We got a little twist here. So I'm going to finish off. You guys know how to finish off. And join you back when I have my starter piece made. And our starter piece has been made on this side. But I just wanted to give a quick reminder. Make sure you're doing your counts or your folds to make sure your dragonfly shape matches up. And so do your ends. I happen to have 7 at this time on each side, so I am matching up just fine. And, yep, you guessed it, we're doing more double crochets until we get to the center, which would be the second part of our little tail. Anybody believe that dragonflies are magical out there? I do. One of my favorite books as a child, of course, was Flowers. The Flower Fairies with their dragonflies that they rode. Alright, here we go. Right on top, and then you're simply, I told you this is so easy, you're simply doing double crochets. And again, if you need to mark the center space for the tail, just like you do the spine, go ahead and do that. We're coming up on that. And I'll lay it flat so you can see. Two more. Double crochet. Chain one, making the second section of our three-part dragonfly shape for shawl or scarf. And continuing on, double crochet. All right, I think you guys have that. So what we're going to do is we're going to repeat that. You're going to continue your double crochets. You're going to do your spine part. And you're going to come all the way over here and do the exact same thing. Chain one right in that space. So let's do that together, and I will be right back. Welcome back. Our dragonfly is really taking shape now, isn't it? Now, I have 19 from this space to the very end. If yours doesn't match, that's okay, as long as they're equal. You're doing your own project, perhaps your own count, using a different double crochet pattern but adding a shape in. That's fine, because remember when we added the shape here in the simple scarf, your shape is going to be dependent on how many crochets you do around it. Very flexible, very easy. And I've already did my chain three and two double crochet in the same spot starter piece. And yes, we are double crocheting all the way up to the tail and chaining one again. That will make our very last piece for the three-part dragonfly shape for scarf or shawl. So I'll do one half with you. And I'm starting to see a slight change in color. I do like the slow changing colors for the dragonfly shape. It's a little complicated shape with many small pieces. Oh, you know, and I forgot to tell you guys, I did a test piece. If you look on my Instagram account, it's just a purple Pound of Love by Lion Brand in lavender. Boy, if you could do like that scarf I showed you just a second ago and make a baby blanket or a throw for yourself out of Pound of Love, works up just fine. You don't need a self-striping yarn to do this. You can use a solid, anything you have in your house. I also think the Red Heart yarn called Dragonfly would make a really, really pretty shawl as well. And yeah, I'm tangled up only because I'm around a camera. So what I'm going to do is I am going to do the last two double crochet. I'm going to chain one and finish my double crochet to the spine and do the other side and meet you back, because I want to show you how to do the transition row between shapes. And that's where the stinger comes in. So meet me back. And we're back. Now you can see on this side, we've got our three-part dragonfly tail and our two wings. We've double crochet all the way up to the spine and did our usual two double crochet, chain two, two double crochet. And I'm right back at the third tail of our last one. And again, if you need to place a stitch marker on the ends of these tails, because we're not done with them yet, so you remember where they're at, go ahead and do that. I'm at the point where I need to chain one and double crochet into the top, and we'll just double crochet together here. the way to the end. And we're going to put it down real quick and take a look before we finish off. So that's the basic pattern. But we've got one more row to do together before this shape is finalized. And this is going to be called the stinger. This is placing a single double crochet smack in the middle. So finish off your piece, do your double crochet, and I'll meet you there. Just a quick reminder, we've finished our third part and final shape in the dragonfly, and we matched up our sides. I have 21 on each side, so if we fold it, our sides should match perfectly, including the little shape there. Always check. I've chained three up and did two double crochet in the same space, our starter piece. Now we are double crocheting this whole thing now. This is that line here that is a solid double crochet, including inside the tail. And that's why I call that the stinger. Because to me, that looks like a sting, but do know that dragonflies do not sting, nor do they bite. However, if you are lucky enough to catch one, they will make it known they don't want to be held. They have very strong jaws. And did you know the cousin to a dragonfly is a damselfly? A damselfly, however, is slightly different in the fact that a dragonfly's wings flat against the body. They lie flat against the body. I thought that was pretty interesting. Do join me on Instagram, Lisa Pine Notes. I posted that little fun fact about our dragonflies, as well as a few other, as I was researching this shape to do for this wonderful shawl here. I knew I've heard of damselflies, but to tell you the truth, I could not pick one out, except that dragonflies are very iridescent. I love how iridescent they are. Okay, we're approaching our tail. Again, use stitch markers to remind you. If you work super fast and you're afraid you're going to skip it, okay, double crochet. And double crochet. This is what I call the stinger. And double crochet. There you go. Your dragonfly shape is now complete with that stinger in there. So do join me. Let's finish off. Do our spine piece. Remember to put your stinger in your other dragonfly shape. And join me when we turn one more time. And here we are. We have a full set of dragonfly shapes on each side. So what does that mean if we want to grow our dragonfly shawl? Well, that means depending how many rows you have between shapes is how many shapes you need to count out. Now remember, our basic shape is 8 plus 1 because you're going to double crochet on the 9th. 8 plus 1 to double crochet on the 9th. So we have this set of 17 right here, and the body is a single crochet. I'm sorry. So we have this set of 17 we have to count for. So to grow your shawl with more shapes, you're going to figure out how many spaces you want between shapes. And I'll give a good example of this using the scarf pattern I'm working on. Here's a dragonfly shape, and I did 1, 2, 3, 4. I did 4 spaces here. My next dragonfly, I only did 2 because I'm playing with the pattern. I'm not exactly sure how many spaces I want between that. But if you move it to a shawl, you're going to have to count depending how many rows you put between shapes, and everybody's different. If you want more solid material and you have the yarn to do that, because that's going to take more yarn up, go ahead and make another row a double crochet. But the example I'm talking about, I already did here. Okay, you're going to end off with your double crochet. You're going to make your chain piece of 3. You're going to do your bumpers, which are 2. You'll do your chain 8, single crochet, skipping 8 spaces down here. You're going to do your chain 8, skipping 8 spaces down here. The double crochet, now go back to the beginning if you don't remember how to do these shapes, or for the first couple times need a little help. Now what I had to do was count from here, and I ended up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have 6. That's going to get me to my spine piece over here. So let's do that together and see if I counted correctly. We're making a chain of 8. Remember, make your chains neatly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'm telling you this so you can make your project customizable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on the 9th, this is his body. It's a single crochet. Do that nice and loosely because we'll be working with it next round. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm just going to recount that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I thought I had an extra guy in there. That's all right. That's why we always count. You're going to count 8 spaces here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And in the 9th, double crochet to grow that wing back out. And here we go. Your 2 bumpers are left. It worked out perfect by counting. I only did 1 row between patterns. Some people may want 2, 3. You just take the basic shape, and that's what all I've been working with. Just take the basic shape and count how many. This is the spine, so I'm chaining 2. We're going to work on the other side and just mirror it. This is just a mirror. You're going to do your 2 bumpers. You're going to chain 8. You're going to count spaces here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on the 9th, single crochet. This is the dragonfly's body. Keep it nice and loose. And 8 more. I'm going to go back and check real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on the 9th, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And on the 9th, double crochet, we're opening that wing back up. Now, take a look. What did you do on the other side here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's what we're going to do over here. 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, chain 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, count your spaces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and on the ninth, single crochet, loosely, because we'll be working with that stitch. Now it may look like you don't have enough spaces here, and this is why we're doing this together. Watch this magic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On the ninth, double crochet. Open that wing back up. Bumper 1. Bumper 2. And I hope I left this loose enough. On that single crochet. Yes, I did. Yay. 3. I love it when it works out like this. 2 and 3. After all, it is just yarn. If it didn't, I would just pull back. Frog it. There you go. And now you're ready to begin doing the next set of dragonflies, because after you get this base first wing chain down, it all becomes so much easier to continue on with your shawl. The first row of wing is always the hardest, but right now you guys can go back to the beginning and do your second one where you double crochet in here. Work out your spaces. Remember, you're going to be double crocheting there. And enjoy. Well, I hope this quick tutorial helped you with your dragonfly shapes out there. And I do appreciate all the kind and lovely comments from when I was sick and lost my voice for a month. But truthfully, we all know I was fighting that in February too in my weekly videos. So I hope each and every one of you have a safe, healthy, and happy April. And what do we say? We say, make it a great day, and let's crochet! Take care, everybody. Goodbye.